Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about what is state function and what are the properties related to that. So it is much more important to understand the state function because there are many properties that are behaving like a state function. And what are those? Let us talk about it. So talking about the state function, so let us know that is what is actually a state function. So any property of a system whose value depends on the current state of the system and is independent on the path followed to reach that state is called as state function. It means what? I will tell you about this thing also. So let me give you a short example like pressure, volume, temperature. This U stands for internal energy, H stands for enthalpy. This all are basically state function, which means that this depends on the initial stage and initial state and the final state of a particular system. So the properties, these are the properties that depends on the initial state and the final state. So let me give you an example of a reaction, suppose or a condition in which suppose a gas has been enclosed in a container, for example this one. Suppose this is a container and in which a gas has been enclosed. A piston. So in this case the gas will have a particular volume as V, it will also have a pressure that is P, and the temperature is also being maintained in that case, so therefore it will be T. So therefore pressure, volume and temperature, now in this case, that is now in initial case, let me name it as P1, V1 and T1. So after, suppose if it changes, suppose if the piston goes down, so what will happen? This piston suppose if has gone down, so then there will be the change in pressure also, there will be change in volume, and suppose if the temperature is been also change, because if pressure increases, suppose, and in that case suppose the temperature, the internal temperature has been increased, so I would name it as T2, P2 and V2. So this is the final thing or the final state. So in this case the pressure is basically dependent on the initial and the final. So these are the state functions like pressure, volume and temperature. This depends on the initial stage and the final state. So let me give you another example by telling the properties. What are the properties of the state function? So these are the properties of state function. The first one is, if the state of the system is specified by fixing the values of some of the state functions, then the value of other state functions get fixed. This means what? I'll explain you. For example, for a gaseous system of a constant mass, if we specify only two state functions, then the third is automatically fixed. This means what? So let me give an example. Suppose we know or suppose if we consider a gas has been enclosed in a container, or it has been enclosed in a cylinder having a particular pressure, volume and having temperature. And that gas also has a specific mass. So if we know the ideal gas equation, that is nothing but PV is equals to nRT. And in this case, what we are going to do, suppose if we have fixed or we have maintained the pressure, the volume to be as it is, as well as we have also maintained that how much mass that we have used in a container, that how much mass of the gas that I have kept in a container. So that mass is being fixed, as well as the pressure is also being maintained, as well as the volume is also being maintained, and this R is nothing but the gas constant. So by keeping this values fixed, I could estimate the third variable. So in this case the third variable will be nothing but the temperature. So we could calculate the temperature and it will adjust itself so that the temperature value will also be remaining constant, will remain constant in that case. So therefore this is nothing but the state function. So the first property of state function is that suppose if you change or if you kept any of this property like pressure, volume and the mass, the constant, then the other property will also be changed and it will can also be determined. So that was the first property that it was talking about. So now let us move on to the second one. So this is the second property which states that when the system undergoes a change of state, the change in any state function depends only on the initial and the final states of the system and not on the path followed during the change. So this means what? Because initially I have said that the state functions is nothing but basically those properties which depends on the initial and final stage. And in this case, it is talking about or it gives a detail that state function depends on the initial and final state. So let me give you an example in this case. Suppose this is a graph of pressure versus volume. So suppose I have considered a and I'm maintaining the temperature has to be constant, so therefore I have written as temperature is constant. Suppose, so in this case what I see is if I consider a gas having a particular pressure, suppose like having a particular pressure of P and having a volume of V. So this is the initial point, suppose, if I've considered, and for that I would name it as P1 and V1. These are the coordinates. Suppose if we have increased the volume, suppose in this case, suppose I want to increase the volume, and as you know that if the volume increases, then the pressure will decrease because according to the Boyle's law. So therefore, now the new state, that is, if this is the volume that I have increased and I know that the pressure will go on decreasing or it has been decreased. So this is the one which will have the pressure as P2 and volume as V2. So what if I have to reach from P1 to V2, or if I have to reach from V1 to V2, so there are various paths that I could follow. The first path is I could come straight, so means the graph could come straight in this manner also. So suppose this is the path 1. The another path is suppose this one, I have considered this as path 2, and the last, or there would be many, there are many possibilities, but for in this case, just for showing, suppose this is the third path which makes the system to convert the pressure P1 to pressure P2. So in this case, three paths have been followed, and we could reach from V1 to V2 also. It means we can change the volume from V1 to V2 also, but in this case we are not considered with the path, we are considered with the, yes, we are considered with the state of the pressure and the state of the volume, because this are the initial, this is the initial state and this is the final state. So therefore this depends on the state but not on the path of the process. So that's the reason state functions are applicable to those properties which are dependent on the initial state and the final state. And that was the main thing about what are state functions. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you'll share this video with the friends too, and try to do more and more kind of concept and share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to EKDA channel. Thank you so much.